how do we determine good from bad? In most cases, it's pretty simple. We rely on people we know or trust to give us their opinion. In Star Trek Fleet Command, I believe it's the same case. So, what determines good research from bad? Our first go-to is always the intrinsic value placed on that research. For example, if something costs you, you might consider it a lot of resources. So say if something costs you a few million dilithium, you may think it's pretty valuable, right? I myself value this process of thinking, but when you may have finite resources, it's always good to consider player opinions too. That's why it's always good to ask you, the players, on what you think it's worth, especially in this new TOS arc. If you're not aware or just need a refresher, we had a whole bunch of new normal research and prime research become available in the game, not to mention the new officers too. Now, I'm certainly no expert, but I do want to know which research to use and upgrade for the future. After all of our resources are finite. So I put the question to you guys, and we got a bunch of results. So take a look at this. Favorite research by far from the new patch seems to be the Dvor Latinum mining improvements. People love the idea of being able to mine a lot of Latinum. It's a resource which is great on Lat Mondays, can be used for a quick buy-in of almost anything in the game, but recently something has happened to the Latinum supply. More specifically, let's just say that the Dvor has had a glitch. What do I mean by this? Well, I'm talking about the unintended anomaly whereby the Dvor mines Latinum incredibly fast. The developer reason behind this is unknown to us, but it's suspected that the new research or even the new primes are to blame. Now, an incredibly fast Dvor, you'd think, is pretty great. Mine all the Latinum you want, right? Well, unless you take advantage of Dvor mining improvements and protected cargo, you'll be overmining, like, constantly. Unless you're in the game 24/7, and I know many of you are, then you may not, like the new upgraded Dvor, the new anomaly Dvor. On the other hand, utilizing Dvor mining and protected cargo research makes a lot of sense. Until it doesn't. You're just reducing the effects of the glitch by protecting your cargo. And you do this by spending your resources. So it can get a little bit crazy at times. So don't get me wrong, it's great that the developers have introduced Dvor mining and protected cargo research, but something on this level needs to be tweaked, especially when we have events like Lat Mondays coming up. So going back now into research, a lot of people like the frequency modulated cost efficiency, and it's a given. People seem to love the USS Franklin. Now, swarm events during the week haven't really been worth it recently in my view, since they changed the rewards a little. Swarm Sundays are really where the proper rewards are at. So for ages, you know, I haven't been able to level up my Franklin, but hopefully with this research, with this frequency modulator cost efficiency research, and even future updates, it'll be much easier. So now let's move on to the primes. So in terms of the new primes, all three are really pretty good. Highly recommend getting all of them if you can, either now or, you know, when they go on sale. The viewer's favorite seems to be a mix between Prime Latinum Refining and Prime Active Nano Probes Refining, both at 39%. So while Prime Borg Rewards is still 22%, this is surprising. So, you know, I think the benefits of Prime Borg Rewards could be huge, especially for the free-to-play players, and it essentially means that you can get double the rewards for faction credits and better rewards from the Latinum Antique Refinery. So what does this mean? Well, the more faction credits you have, the more ship blueprints you can get in the future. Okay, now moving on. active nanoprobes reminds me a lot of the Borg Ark. You know, I really struggled to get my Vidar up to spec for Borg cubes. Not sure if it made a difference during that arc, but I think, you know, I got it up to tier 6 at least. My point is, the developers are trying to bring back the nanoprobe excitement. Maybe for a new Borg arc? Well, who knows? But this has really got me thinking, it's time to bring out that dusty Vidar. Again, this isn't my favorite prime, but it's pretty cool one to have. Now, prime latinum refining, I don't even need to explain this. A lot of people like to refine latinum, both paying players and free players, but as I mentioned earlier, up until recently, it was incredibly frustrating to mine and refine latinum. Unless you had 10 of 10, it was painful to say the least. So prime lat refining, probably one of my favorite primes, as I'm aiming to fully upgrade my Devor, highly recommend you get it at some point. All right, so I've gone a little bit over the primes, the normal research in this video, but there is one topic I have not yet covered, the new TOS officers. As of yet, I haven't determined who McKinnon or DuPont are in the Kelvin universe. Are they from the comics? Are they not? I don't know. But that's okay though, because their abilities are pretty good. So you, the viewer, decided that your new favorite TOS officer is in fact Prime Kirk. But very close behind that is Officer DuPont with 30%. Now, Kirk is excellent on ships like the Enterprise, but people seem to really value DuPont. He's very similar to 10 of 10, and if you don't have him, you really should. DuPont increases the rate of G3 crystal ore and gas by an X percentage, not to mention his protected cargo ability, another essential officer for Lat Mondays. So ultimately, this arc, as I've stated in previous videos, is shaping up to be one of the best. Through the primes, the research, the officers, and the subsequent glitches in Lat mining, it's been a pretty exciting time for SCFC. So this is Fortis signing off. Stay safe out there.